There's a great line by Albert Camus. He says, life should be lived to the point of tears. In other words, we should strive to be moved, to be transported, to be shaken. We all want to be touched by something greater than ourselves. But that's a difficult thing to do. And so I've become really obsessed with the idea of experience design, which is basically hacking experience, hacking subjectivity. Now, what is experience? What is first-person subjectivity? Well, in a way, it's that evanescent flux of sensation and perception that is, in a way, all we have and all we are. It's the multidimensional matrix of first-person experience unfolding moment by moment. It's the voice in our head that lets us know that we exist. So how can we inform? How can we script that narrative? How can we be the director of our own movie, so to speak? And it turns out that the trick is attention. To hack experience, you gotta hack attention. And a fantastic article by Diana Slattery says that what is required is the capture and control of attention to create a state of deep immersion, of deep absorption. And this kind of immersion is a prerequisite for any kind of interpersonal persuasion, transformation, or education to take place. In other words, any kind of phase change in consciousness, any kind of true inspiration, transformation, you know, catharsis requires this deep immersion, this state of focused attention. And again, that being the key to experience, that being the key to scripting subjectivity, the narrative of your own life, then that seems to be ultimately the key to happiness, the meaning of our lives. This kind of deconstructing of our consciousness and tweaking our perceptual apparatus to kind of engineer a kind of neural nirvana, to trade in real virtualities, to trade in subjectivities, that is what it means to be human, and that is what we are increasingly becoming masters at doing, at distilling, at creating, and I love that.